Hello everyone, welcome to my AutoCAD tutorial. I'm going to create a four-story structure with three bays on the y-axis and four bays in the x-axis. I will start with the foundation. So we are in a 2D window of the AutoCAD. First, we will make a foundation 2 meters by 2 meters cross section. So type brick, then click anywhere on the AutoCAD window, drag interior dimension 2, 2, enter. Now you have the foundation. My column would be 400 millimeter by 400 millimeter. So we will just offset these foundations by a distance of 0.8 of a meter. Type O, offset. Enter the distance, 0.8, enter. Click the object and click inside. So this inscribed object is our column. Now we were going to lay out this column. So we will attain a 3 base on y-axis and 3 base on x-axis. We will going array command to be used for this one. ER, then select the objects by rubber band, enter. Select rectangular. Now the AutoCAD will give you a pre-configured of your objects. So all you have to do there is to customize this one. Type column call, then 5, enter. Now you have already 5 columns and foundations, so you put the distance between your columns and foundations, let's say 6 meters, enter. So our x-axis already have 4 bays. Now let's go to our rows. Type R, enter. Then number of rows 4, enter. Except so we are in a 2D drawing. Here we have this WCS. Just click right here anywhere you want, which comfortable for you to work with. So here my foundation thickness is 600 milli, so I have to change the elevation of my column to 600 on z-axis. Just type X for explode, select any of the objects, enter. Now if you select the object, it is independent from the other. Now, we have to change the elevation of our column to 600 millimeter in a positive z direction. Type negative ch, change, select your columns, after selecting all the columns, enter, press enter, then proceed to properties, type P, select elevation, then specify new elevation, just type 0.6 of a meter, that is equivalent to 600 millimeter, then enter. Enter. Now you notice that the columns were moved in a z direction. We have to extrude our foundation so we can show the thickness in a solid form. Now you would know that these are all region which is ready for extrusion. Now if you want to extrude, type X, select all foundation, after selecting all your foundation, press enter, then give the distance of your extrusion, which 0.6, then enter. So now in a solid form. So we are also to extrude our columns. So we have a four-story structure. Our ground to second floor is 3.5 meters. The rest is 3 meters. And our foundation below from the natural grid line foundation, but the bottom of our foundations is 1.5 meters from the, let's extrude our column by 13.6. So click all columns you have, after selecting all your columns, press enter, then input your 13.6 meters length. This is already on the top of the structure. Now I want to rotate these objects, press escape to exit the command, then press enter. So from here you can create a rectangle for your beams and girders. So I will just create a rectangle in this area, tracing from this point to the other corner of, so I have a rectangle right here. I will copy this rectangle to hasten the process. CO, copy, click the object. I will choose this as a reference point so I can paste it very easily on the other side of the column. And there, then enter pro exit the command. So you have the your rectangle. Next, you have to copy all this again. Select this one, select this one, select this one. Choose a good reference point. I will choose this area, this point. Click in here. Click in there. Click in there. It's just a matter of selecting a very good points best. Now on the other side, same rectangle. Select in this area, on this point rather, choose the other one, repeat the process, copy this one. Select the object, choose a point, and paste it there, there, and there. Then exit the command, copy once again. But this time you have to select the four objects, then enter, then choose again a point for your reference, then paste it there. Just click it, then there. So in that process you will hasten the copy and paste procedure. So what you would do, either you extrude it or just simply change the elevation of this object. But for me, I would change the elevation first before I would extrude. So the same command, negative ch, change elevation. You have to select the object. It is very tedious work, but along the way you will learn most effective technique. So there, after making sure that everything is selected, please enter, then properties, P, enter, elevation. So we have 4.6 distance from the top of the foundation. enter, enter. So I will show you another technique so you can select the objects you want to work with easily. So just click this tab, our WCS. So from here you can rubber band the objects you can choose, just simply avoiding other objects that you don't want to be selected. So rig for region, then select this object, this object, this object, as well as this one, this one, this one, and this one. See, then enter. So we have the total of 31 regions created. Just enter again to exit the command. So let's go back to control. I am very comfortable to work with this. So in this way you can see it. Now you have to extrude, select all object, now all the objects were selected, select enter. We're going to extrude by negative 0.55, enter. Now we have our beams and girder. Next is to copy this one. Copy. Let's go back to 2D. Copy object. Then see. Then back to 3D view. Enter. Select a base point, top of the beam. Then the displacement, or you might also use the array, but we will use just the displacement. We have 0 on X, 0 on Y, and on Z axis is 3 meters. So there, wait the process again. Zero X, 0 Y, and on Z is 6 meters. And finally, we have 0 X, 0 Y, then 9 on z-axis. There you go. Then just enter to exit the command. Now you cannot appreciate this object in 3D, so we will go into 3D. Just click this one, workspace switching, then 3D modeling. So your ribbon will change. After your ribbon will change, you will go into the view. This one, in the ribbon view, we have 2D frame. Change that. We go to realistic. Now if you want to create a slab, you just draw rectangle, click rectangle, somewhere above. So when we create a region, other elements would not interfere our selection process. So rig, select the object, enter, then extrude, select the object to extrude, enter, negative point one. Enter. Then copy the object, here it's an art to let your imagination fly. Copy. Then again, you have to be very careful of choosing a point. So here is the best point to have a reference. Then we'll copy it on our second floor. There we go. We copy it in our third floor and to our fourth floor. Then exit the cup. At this time, we are going to move. Just move the object. You know, it's just a technique. Then same, the best point to execute. Copy and paste. There we go. So that's it. So here, let's just say that is our structure. We go to our layout one. Okay. Let us say we will create a rectangular that is 420 by 297 mm, and zoom in real time. E, enter. Then, so we will configure our snap. This is our object snap. We will take the midpoint because we want to create two views in our layout. So close it, just clicking anywhere on the window. Then MB, that is multi view. From this corner to the center of the other one. And we make the other one also the same. This one to here. Now we have two multi view. So we'll create a dynamic view. Double click in this area, just type DV for a dynamic view, then select object. You have to select the entire object by a rubber band there, then enter. We will use this distance. See, like 4 times or PS paper space. Our structure. Type PS for a paper space. Zoom E. So that is our structure. Well, thank you for watching. Hope you get some idea from my work. Bye.